Hi guys! Welcome sa Engineered Math Channel. Sa video na to ay ituturo ko sa inyo ang arithmetic sequence. So kung gusto niyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. Okay, so this time ay ituturo ko naman sa inyo yung another topic sa algebra, which is arithmetic sequence. So, when we say sequence, para siyang sequence of number na merong sinusunod na rule. Okay? So, pag sinabing sequence, sabi, it is a function whose domain is the set of positive integers, usually a set of positive consecutive integers, starting with 1. The function values a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, a sub 4, a sub 5, ... until a sub n are called the terms of the sequence. Okay, so, makukonsider natin na function yung isang sequence kung saan yung kanyang domain or yung values ng kanyang n is a set of integers. So, magsimula siya pwede sa 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Okay? So, yung tinatawag nating a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, up to a sub n, siya yung tinatawag na terms ng sequence. Okay? So, halimbawa, given daw na meron tayong sequence na a sub n equals 3n minus 1. So, itong a sub n parang a of n, right? Function of n. So, ito yung formula niya. 3n minus 1. So, itong n, pwede nating palitan ng any integer values, which usually nga daw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, para makuha natin yung n term nitong sequence. So, kung hanapin natin yung a sub 1, papalitan lang natin yung n ng 1. So, kaya 3 times 1 minus 1 is equal to 3 minus 1 or 2. So, a sub 1 to. Then, a sub 2, palitan naman natin yung n ng 2. So, 3 times 2 is 6 minus 1 is 5. And so on, a sub 3, so palitan yung n ng 3. So, 3 times 3 minus 1 or 9 minus 1 or 8. And a sub 4, 3 times 4 minus 1 or 12 minus 1 or 11. So, therefore, the terms of this sequence given by 3n minus 1 is, yung first term niya is 2, second term is 5, third term is 8, and fourth term is 4. So, pwede nyo pang tuloy-tuloy letting n equals 5, 6, 7, and so on kasi infinite naman yung domain nitong ating arithmetic sequence. Okay? Okay, so ngayon, dumako na tayo sa pinaka-topic, which is one type of sequence, which is the arithmetic sequence. So, actually, marami pa tayong sequence. Meron tayong geometric, harmonic, Fibonacci, and so on. So, ito muna yung didiscuss natin, arithmetic sequence. Okay? So, I think ito rin yung pinakamadaling sequence. So, a sequence is arithmetic if each pair of consecutive terms differ by the same amount called the common difference in the sequence. So, masasabi raw na arithmetic sequence, yung isang sequence, kung yung bawat terms daw ng ating sequence na yon is may common difference. So, pag sinubtract mo yung sumunod na term dun sa sinundan niya, dapat kapareho lang din doon sa another kasunod na term dun sa sinundan niya. Common difference. So, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ... So, arithmetic sequence siya kasi pag kinuha natin yung difference nung sumunod sa sinundan niya, let's say 2 minus 1, 1, right? Then 3 minus 2, 1 then, 4 minus 3, 1 then, 5 4. Minus 5, 1, 6 minus 5, 1. So, laging merong common difference yung bawat terms. Okay? Next, 1 fourth, 1 half, 3 fourths, 1 3 halves. So, pag sinubrak natin, 1 half minus 1 fourth, 1 fourth, right? 3 fourths minus 1 half, 1 fourth. 1 minus 3 fourths, 1 fourth. 3 halves minus 1. Sorry, nagkamali siguro. Dapat, supposed to be, dapat ano lang to. Kasi kapag 3 halves, 1 half na yon, right? So, dapat 1 plus 1 fourth or 5 over 4, right? Okay, so therefore, may common difference sila lahat na 1 fourth. So, therefore, arithmetic sequence ito. Okay? Next, 10, 6, 2, negative 2, negative 6. So, 6 minus 10 is negative 4. So, this time, negative yung common difference. 2 minus 6, negative 4. Negative 2 minus 2, negative 4. Negative 6 minus negative 2 is negative 4. So, lahat ng difference ng bawat term is negative 4. So, therefore, arithmetic sequence nito. So, ganun yung concept natin ng arithmetic sequence. Merong common difference yung bawat terms. Okay? Okay, so for the arithmetic sequence, meron tayong formula for the n term. So, it is given by a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So, ito yung parang function of n nung arithmetic sequence natin. So, yung a sub 1, siya yung first term. Yung n is yung number of terms. Tapos, yung d is the common difference. And yung a sub n, siya yung n term. So, pwede nating malaman or mapredict kung anong value ng terms kapag alam natin yung common difference ng arithmetic sequence, tapos alam din natin kung anong hahanapin na term. So, let's say, meron tayong a sub n as, let's say yung first term natin is 1 plus n minus 1, then common difference, let's say, is 2. So, therefore, ito yung n term natin for the arithmetic sequence. So, whatever value nung n nung gusto natin hanapin, let's say the 20th term, papalitan lang natin ng 20 itong n, masasolve na natin yung a sub 20 or yung 20th term. So, let's do that. So, a sub 20 is equal to 1 plus 20 minus 1 times 2. Or 1 plus 20 minus 1 is 19 times 2. Or 1 plus 38 is 39. So, therefore, the 20th term of the sequence is 39. So, ito lang gagamitin natin formula whenever we encounter an arithmetic sequence. Okay? So, let's start to solve some examples para ma-illustrate natin yung formula for arithmetic sequence. So, for the first one, we have find the 11th term of the sequence 12, 15, 18, 21. Okay, so given tayo ng first four terms ng sequence, hanapin daw natin yung 11th term. So, whenever we encounter sequence problem, try muna natin i-determine kung anong type siya. So, pwede yung hanapin kung merong common difference ba, common ratio, and so on. Saka yung apply yung formula. So, check nga natin kung arithmetic ito. So, pag sinubtract natin itong 15 minus 12, we have 3. 18 minus 15, 3 din. 21 minus 18, 3 din. So, therefore, common yung mga difference nila, right? So, therefore, arithmetic sequence ito. So, pwede natin gamitin yung n term for the arithmetic sequence. So, a sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So, yung a sub 1, yung first term is 12 plus n minus 1 times yung common difference is 3, right? So, pag hinanap natin ngayon yung 11th term, papalitan natin yung n ng 11. So, a sub 11 is equal to 12 plus n, so 11 minus 1 times 3. So, 12 plus 11 minus 1 is 10 times 3. So, simplify, 12 plus 10 times 3 is 30. So, 12 plus 30 is 42. So, therefore, the 11th term of the arithmetic sequence is 42. Okay? Next, we have, in the arithmetic sequence 5, 9, 13, 17, which term is 401? Okay, so this time, given ulit tayo ng arithmetic sequence, right? So, apat na terms yung binigay. Tapos, ang tanong, hanapin daw natin kung anong term si 401 or ano yung n na yon for 401. So, let's say we have the formula a sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d, right? So, ang nawawala is itong n. So, pag pinlagin natin yung mga value, yung first term natin or a sub 1 is 5, right? Plus n unknown, so n minus 1 times d. So, d, mahanap natin yung common difference. So, minus natin itong 9 minus 5, 4, right? 13 minus 4, 4 din. 17 minus 13, 4 din. So, therefore, common difference is 4. So, n minus 1 times 4. So, given tayo ng a sub n, which is etong 401, right? So, pag in-equate natin ito sa 401, pwede nating ma-solve ngayon dito si n, linear equation. So, transpose ko dito si 5. So, 401 minus 5 equals n minus 1, 4. So, ano yung 401 minus 5? 3, 9, 6, right? Equals n minus 1. Then, divide both sides by 4. So, cancel. So, ano yung 396 divided by 4? 99, right? Equal n minus 1. So, therefore, transpose ko na lang itong 1. Magiging 99 plus 1 is equal to n. Or, therefore, 99 plus 1 is 100. So, therefore, 401 is the 100 term of the sequence. Kasi n is equal to 100. Okay? Next, we have the 4th term of an arithmetic sequence is 28 and the 15th term is 105. Find the 25th term of the sequence. Okay, so yung given daw is yung 4th term. So, a sub 4, which is 28. And then, yung 15th term, so a sub 15, which is 105. So, find the 25th term of the sequence. So, hanapin daw natin yung a sub 25. So, paano natin ito isasolve? So, pwede natin gamitin dito yung given na a sub 4 equals 28 at a sub 15 equals 105 by substituting it to the n term of an arithmetic sequence. So, di ba? A sub n is equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So, parang wala tayo ditong a sub 1 tsaka d. So, pwede tayong bumuo ng dalawang equations given this condition. So, yung a sub 4, ano? 28, right? Equals, anon si a sub 1? Plus, so since yung subscript natin is 4 kasi a sub n, so n is 4. So, pwede natin palitan dito sa n as 4. Then, 4 minus 1 times yung d anon din. Okay? Then, pag sinimplify natin, we have 28 is equal to a sub 1 plus 4 minus 1 is 3 times d. So, plus 3d. Equation 1. Then, equation 2, ito naman. So, a sub 15. So, 105 is equal to a sub 1 unknown plus this time, n is 15, right? Kasi yun yung subscript. So, 15 minus 1 times d na unknown pa. So, simplify. 105 equals a sub 1 plus 15 minus 1 is 14. So, plus 14d. So, ito yung equation 2. So, sige, pagsamahin ko. 105 is equal to a sub 1 plus 14d. Equation 2. So, solve ngayon natin itong dalawang equations for a sub 1 tsaka d. So, subtract na lang natin para cancel agad itong si a sub 1. So, 28 minus 105 is what? Negative 77, right? And then, cancel na nga si a sub 1. So, 3d minus 14d is what? Negative 11d. So, divide both sides by negative 11 to solve for d. D is equal to negative 77 divided by negative 11. Positive 7. So, therefore, the common difference is 7. Now, to solve for a sub 1, gamitin na lang natin itong equation 1. So, 28 is equal to a sub 1 plus 3d. D nakuha na natin as 7, right? So, we have 28 is equal to a sub 1 plus 3 times 7 yung sinasalib natin na d, 21. Then, transpose ito si 21, we have 28 minus 21 equals a sub 1. So, 28 minus 21 is 7, right? So, therefore, yung pinaka-n term natin is yung a sub 1 is 7 plus n minus 1 times d na 7. Okay, so whenever na pahanapin tayo ng any term, pwede na. Plugin na lang natin yung n. So, ang hinahanap is 25th term, right? So, n is 25. So, pag hinanap natin yun, we have a sub 25 is equal to 7 plus 25 minus 1 times 7. So, 7 plus 25 minus 1 is 24 times 7. 7 plus 24 times 7 is 168, right? So, 7 plus 168 is 175. So, therefore, the 25th term is 175. Okay? Next, we have, what is the arithmetic mean of 4 fifths and 3 fourths? Okay, so pag sinabing arithmetic mean, siya yung pumapagitna doon sa dalawang numbers. For example, 1, 2, 3. So, arithmetic sequence ito, right? Kasi may common difference sila na 1. So, sa tatlong term na to, yung 2, yung arithmetic mean, kasi siya yung pumagitna dito sa 1 at 3. Okay? So, ngayon hanapin daw natin yung pumagitna dito sa 4 over 5 tsaka 3 fourths. So, may formula tayo dyan. Arithmetic mean for 2 terms is a sub 1 plus a sub 3 over 2. Okay? So, yung first at last, add mo, then divide 2. Okay? So, therefore, pag ginawa natin yun, we have 4 fifths plus 3 fourths divided by 2. So, ano yung 4 fifths plus 3 fourths? LCD is 20, right? 20 divided by 5 is 4 times 4 is 16 plus 20 divided by 4 is 5 times 3, 15. All over 2. So, we have 16 plus 15 is 31 over 20 all over 2. So, pag nag-divide tayo, ginagawa natin tong reciprocal, right? Itong denominator. So, parang 2 over 1 to. So, magiging 31 over 20 times reciprocal ng 2 over 1 or 1 half. So 31 times 1 is 31 over 20 times 2 is 40. So therefore the arithmetic mean is 31 over 40. Okay? Next we have insert 5 arithmetic means between 3 and 45. Okay, so this time mag-i-insert naman daw tayo ng 5 arithmetic means between 3 and 45. So pwede 'yon ha, kahit hindi lang isa 'yung maging arithmetic mean na i-insert nyo. So pwedeng marami. So ibig sabihin kung mula 3 tsaka 45, mag-i-insert tayo ng 5 arithmetic mean, magdadagdag tayo ng ilang terms? 5 in between kasi 5, right? So 1 2 3 4 5. So 1 2 3 4 5. So, in total, ilan yung magiging terms natin? 5 yung i-insert plus yung una tsaka dulo, 7. So, 7 term, right? So, kapag mag-insert tayo ng arithmetic mean, hanapin na lang natin yung common difference. Para, pag nakuha natin yung common difference, yung second term, addan lang natin yung first term ng D. And then, yung sumunod pa, yung pangatlo, kung anong nakuha natin second term, addan lang natin ng D. Add lang ng add ng D hanggang ma-fill up natin yung i-insert na mean. Okay? So, para magawa, mahanap natin yung D, alam natin yung first term, right? E sub 1, which is 3. Tapos, yung last term, 45, which is, sabi ko nga, 7 term. So, E sub 7 is 45. Equals, yung formula natin, diba? E sub 1 plus N minus 1 times D. So, E sub 1 is 3 na. Plus, N. So, yung N natin is 7 minus 1, then D yung hahanapin. So, 45, transpose si 3, 45 minus 3, right? So, equals yun saan? 42. Equals, 7 minus 1 is 60. So, divide both sides by 6 to solve for D. D is equal to 7. So, therefore, alam na natin yung common difference na 7. Alam lang natin tong unang term ng 7, 10. Then, next, 10 plus 7, 17. 17 plus 7, 24. 24 plus 7, 31. 31 plus 7, 38. And then 38 plus 7, lastly, 45. So therefore, the 5 arithmetic means between 3 and 14 are 10, 17, 24, 31, and 38. Okay? Okay, so I think that's it for this video, arithmetic sequence. So madali lang naman yung arithmetic sequence. Basta kabisaduhin nyo lang yung general formula niya, which is yung a sub n equal to a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So, kung alam yung formula at kabisado nyo, then kahit anong tanong sa arithmetic sequences, masasagutan nyo. Okay? So, sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.